Hey there, YouTube. This is Greg on me2005, and today I want to show you guys 2019 Chevrolet Silverado powertrain specs. These are only on two engines, guys. Okay, and I got this from gmauthority.com. Anybody can go and check it out. So let's see, 2019 Silverado engine power and torque ratings revealed. Again, this is not fuel economy ratings, but they're going to show you. There's only on two engines, the 5.3 and the 6.2. So we're going to move it up to here so you can see the whole screen. Okay, and they tell you right here, they got the new 5.3 with 355 horsepower and 383 foot-pounds of torque, and it's with an 8-speed automatic transmission. Now, the 5.3 liter, the old one, it says, has 355 horsepower, 383 foot-pounds of torque with a 6-speed. So that looks the same. And honestly, to tell you guys the truth, that's pretty sad. I figured 2019 Silverado, they were going to up the numbers on this. I figured they were going to try to be competitive with Ram and be competitive, especially with the F-150 with the 5-liter V8. Now, this is not competitive. This is kind of pitiful, tell you the truth. I'm really disappointed on GM if these are the actual true specs on the two engines, but I pretty much believe it from GM Authority. This 5.3 should at least have 400 horsepower and at least have maybe 420 foot-pounds of torque. I'm disappointed on that engine right there, but there is the numbers on the 5.3, and the 6.2 from the new one is 425 horsepower and 450 foot-pounds of torque with a 10-speed, and the old one was 420 horsepower and 460 foot-pounds of torque with an 8-speed. So the problem I see here is, okay, it's a plus that the new one gained 5 horsepower, but the old one had 10 more foot-pounds of torque than the new one, and also gained from an 8 to a 10-speed. So, I mean, I guess the 6.2 is okay. I was kind of expecting at least 450, 460 horsepower and at least 500 foot-pounds of torque. I'm a little saddened by this. I know they haven't released the diesel horsepower ratings yet or torque, and I guess GM has a couple more engines that they haven't revealed or even mentioned yet, so we can see what those will be eventually. But again, these are not fuel economy ratings yet, so we don't know the fuel economy. The fuel economy may rock. I mean, these numbers may suck right now compared to the competition, but if they get extremely good fuel economy and it's enough power to pull and haul and do what you need, you have to also look at it like that. But at this point in time, if I was in the market to buy a new truck, and I've always bought in GM trucks, I've had a couple Fords in the past, and I've always been a diehard core GM guy, I have to go agree with the Ford fans out there. I'm going on F-150, the 5-liter. A little hard to take in, but this is what it is. Anyways, guys, this is Greg on me2005, signing off, guys.